Chapter 4. After Ehud's death, the Israelites again did what was evil in the Lord's sight. So the Lord handed them over to King Jabin of Hazor, a Canaanite king. The commander of his army was Sisera, who lived in Harosheth Hagoyim. Sisera, who had 900 iron chariots, ruthlessly oppressed the Israelites for 20 years. Then the Israelites cried out to the Lord for help. Deborah, the wife of Lapidoth, was a prophet who had become a judge in Israel. She would hold court under the palm of Deborah, which stood between Ramah and Bethel and the hill country of Ephraim, and the Israelites came to her to settle their disputes. One day she sent for Barak, son of Abinoam, who lived in Kedesh in the land of Naphtali. She said to him,
"This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, commands you. Assemble 10,000 warriors from the tribes of Naphtali and Zebulun at Mount Tabor. I will lure Sisera, commander of Jabin's army, along with his chariots and warriors, to the Kishon River. There, I will give you victory over him."
Barak told her,
"I will go, but only if you go with me."
"Very well,"
she replied.
"I will go with you. But since you have made this choice, you will receive no honor. For the Lord's victory over Sisera will be at the hands of a woman."
So Deborah went with Barak to Kedesh. At Kedesh, Barak called together the tribes of Zebulun and Naphtali, and 10,000 warriors marched up with him. Deborah also marched with them. Now Heber the Kenite, a descendant of Moses' brother-in-law Hobab, had moved away from the other members of his tribe and pitched his tent by the oak at Zeananim near Kedesh. When Sisera was told that Barak, son of Abinoam, had gone up to Mount Tabor, he called for all 900 of his iron chariots and all of his warriors, and they marched from Harosheth Hagoyim to the Kishon River. Then Deborah said to Barak,
"Get ready. Today the Lord will give you victory over Sisera, for the Lord is marching ahead of you."
So Barak led his 10,000 warriors down the slopes of Mount Tabor into battle. When Barak attacked, the Lord threw Sisera and all his charioteers and warriors into a panic. Then Sisera leaped down from his chariot and escaped on foot. Barak chased the enemy and their chariots all the way to Harosheth Hagoyim, killing all of Sisera's warriors. Not a single one was left alive. Meanwhile, Sisera ran to the tent of Jael, the wife of Heber the Kenite, because Heber's family was on friendly terms with King Jabin of Hazor. Jael went out to meet Sisera and said to him,
"Come into my tent, sir. Come in. Don't be afraid."
So he went into her tent, and she covered him with a blanket.
"Please give me some water,"
he said.
"I'm thirsty."
So she gave him some milk to drink and covered him again.
"Stand at the door of the tent,"
he told her.
"If anybody comes and asks you if there is anyone here, say no."
But when Sisera fell asleep from exhaustion, Jael quietly crept up to him with a hammer and tent peg. Then she drove the tent peg through his temple and into the ground, and so he died. When Barak came looking for Sisera, Jael went out to meet him. She said,
"Come, and I will show you the man you are looking for."
So he followed her into the tent and found Sisera lying there dead with the tent peg through his temple. So on that day, Israel saw God subdue Jabin, the Canaanite king. And from that time on, Israel became stronger and stronger against King Jabin until they finally destroyed him.